Morning students, today we are going to learn story writing. So far you have learned listening and reading, isn't it? Yes, today is the first day that you are going to take part the writing part, that is story writing. Have you read the stories before? Yes, we people read too many stories. Have you written any stories before? Yeah, some of you have written few stories. Yes, what is a story? Yes, a story is basically a narrating of real or imaginary events involving real or imaginary people. A story needs to be represented in words necessarily. Even images or moving pictures can narrate a story. A story is generally designed to entertain and send a message across. Isn't it? This is the story. Then how the story should be? The story should be creative, enthusiastic, interested. Isn't it? Yeah. How to write a short story? Shall we see that? We have certain format to write the story writing. First one, we supposed to note all these things. Story is written in past tense. We should not use supernatural characters. That is, we should not use an imaginary characters. Avoid spelling mistakes and grammatical errors should be avoided. Then, start with a clue given in questions. Clue has to be taken from the questions. Ensure clarity of plot. That is, start happily, create a problem, then twist should be there in between the paragraph. Solution should be there before the end. Then end. End of this story. Then logical sequence. While writing the story, your sentences should be in a logical order. That has to be in an arranging order. Then well defined. Whatever you are trying to tell the story, it has to be well defined. Then proper conclusion has to be there. While writing this story writing, we are supposed to follow all these rules. While writing, it should be in the past tense. Supernatural characters should be avoided completely. There should not be any spelling mistakes and grammatical mistakes. Clues has to be taken from the questions. And in our plot, start happily, there should be a problem, there should be some solution, and end, then everything should be in a logical order, well-defined sentences there, then proper conclusions should be there. Next, shall we see the format of this story writing? Title or heading, it is optional. It's your wish. Part 1. First, use phrases like once upon a time, a long, long ago. Similarly, you are supposed to start the story. Then, beginning should catch the reader's attention. In the beginning itself, you should catch the readers. Those who are reading that story, no, their attention should be caught by you. Then introduce characters, how many characters are there in the story, all these things should be introduced by you in the beginning of this paragraph. Then you have to follow the logical sequence, then order should be there, it should be in a coherent way. Then part 2, that is in the second paragraph, develop plot, your plot should be developed by you. Description of an event. What you are going to tell, no, that has to be described in a lengthy way. That incident or accident in a detailed way. The type of plot may be adventurous, scary, mystery, any suspense, comic, etc. Got it? Then, third paragraph, it has to be in a climax. That is end of the story. It should be clear and satisfying. It should be most interesting and unpredictable. No one should predict this is going to be end. No one should predict that. You are that climax is should be different and is satisfied by everyone. Make sure that the story has a moral message. Got it? Then it should be either happy ending or sad ending. This is the format of story writing. Then I am going to tell you one story. Similarly, you are going to write the story at the end. A trip to the zoo. That is the topic or title. Yesterday, I went to the zoo. I went with my mom and dad. When we got there, we went to the shop to buy some food for the animals. After getting the food, we went to the giraffe house. I fed the giraffes some leaves. Before lunch, we went for a ride on an elephant. It was brilliant. After lunch, we fed some birds in the park. At the end of the day, we went home. I was really tired, but it had been a great day. So, actually, I'm telling you a short story. Similarly, you are supposed to write that story. Once again, I will be concluding that what are the things that should be mentioned in the story writing, I am telling you now. That beginning paragraph set up the action or plot, gives background of the story or builds in a way that catches attention. Then in the middle of the part, incidents or events explained in detailed way. It arouses more attention of readers. What should be happen next? What should be happen the other thing like that? It should arouse our intention. Then end of the paragraph should be that a climax, happy or sad ending, moral, unexpected manner. It should be there. This is the format of short story. Now, I am giving you one verb. Take your content book, my dear children. Take page number 32. You go to a zoo late in the evening. You hear strange voices speaking. You try to find the source. Much to your surprise, the animals are talking in human language. One of them is telling the others his story. Can you imagine and write the story? The clues will be given here. The animal will introduce himself, describe the place that he came from, describe other creatures that he lived with, describe how he was caught, describe his likes and dislikes, feelings. Everything should be mentioned. Now you are going to write the story of my life. Got it, my dear children? That is page number 32 in your content book. Utilize it. I hope, children, that you all understood this writing part. Thank you, children.